Now that I'm essentially finished with the Brett Kavanaugh saga, a case where a United States Supreme Court nominee was accused of sexual impropriety, I can go back to focusing on other areas with this channel. So thanks to those who stuck with me. But before that, I'm going to tell you why it's relevant and why I even covered it. I think since we often look at things from multiple angles here on California Carter, it's important to show how easily the bigger issues are overlooked when tribal politics or controversies are involved. For example, and to stay in context, sexual allegations are a profound issue, and the political atmosphere, particularly today, is hyper-partisan. Because of that, many of those who are following the Kavanaugh saga didn't consider how it, and scenarios akin to it, impact and reverberates down to the civilian realm. Employers, our cultural interactions, social nuances, regardless of the confirmation or allegations, the precedent that's being set and exploitation of sensitive issues for political ends is dangerous. If people aren't willing to be impartial, which is what fairness demands, is that truly the proper momentum to get behind? The answer is obvious, or at least it should be, yet the opposite of the obvious is instigated. My more fair-minded political listeners know some of the inherent pitfalls to the left-right paradigm, hyper-partisanship just being one. Just look at what it turned Kavanaugh's confirmation process into. The man is clearly innocent, and to back that fact, even the FBI investigation that mostly opponents were calling for found nothing that speaks to sexual impropriety. You'll no doubt hear cries of limited or narrow process and other petty trivial objections, but the FBI's report only adds a sense of credibility to the notion that Kavanaugh was the target of a political hit job from the start. Also, it seems sexual assault victims have once again had their traumas inappropriately exploited. But now, let me appeal to my spiritual listeners and put it this way. 1 Corinthians 1 through 3 says, "If any of you has a dispute with another, do you dare take it before the ungodly for judgment instead of before the Lord's people? Or do you not know that the Lord's people will judge the world? And if you are to judge the world, are you not competent to judge trivial cases? Do you not know that we will judge angels? How much more the things of this life?" That's right. If we as believers play our cards right, one day we will judge the matters of this world. So get your wits about you now. Like Anita Hill versus Clarence Thomas, this is one for the history books and will have more implications down the road. In the same way that 1991 fiasco made ripples years later, is the same way our current trajectory will be affected. Again, don't think for a second that high-profile instances like these don't shape the tone of the subtle, sometimes overt, everyday social and cultural complexities and nuances. Political prejudice and entirely partisan outlets may be enough to satisfy those who want to shake their fist at their screens, but others are involving themselves in more real-world scenarios. Now, I'm not one to say voting makes a huge difference on the macro level, but on the local levels where your life actually plays out, it's worth casting. In some instances, you do kind of have to be the change you want to see, but if all that means is starting a conversation, casting a vote, or at least being willing to defend your constitutional and God-given rights, it's energy well spent. Much better than exerting yourself trying to articulate facts to people who won't even receive them. But before I close, I should be clear. We all know sexual assault survivors are important and deserve to be heard. Not just women. They don't get all the focus here. Men are sexually abused. We also all know far too many people jump to believe or disbelieve allegations without investigation or evidence. Some sexual assault survivors are now projecting their past traumas onto falsely accused men in some misguided attempt to feel vindicated and justified through taking them down. Things are turning into guilty by allegation rather than the initial presumption of innocence. It's sad to see such a visceral issue being used nefariously for political purposes. It's nothing new, it's just becoming more prominent. But hey, you could have been anywhere else today. Thanks for checking me out. You might as well subscribe. It is free after all. Take care of yourself out there.